I want him to be pleased with what he sees. And that's what Paul is really speaking about here, this self-examination. I want to be really sure that I've put off anything that wouldn't please him. And I've put on everything I possibly can that would please him. So that when I come to the table and he says to me, take, eat, and drink, I'll know he wants to share himself with me. It's really a beautiful moment, isn't it? It's a moment, my friends, for all history. There was a moment in the Garden of Eden when the serpent said, or at least insinuated to Eve, and at least this was what Eve understood was happening. He said, look, take, and eat. There was a moment in the Garden of Gethsemane when the Heavenly Father said to his Son, look, take, and drink. And because of that moment, the Lord Jesus comes to us and he says to us, look, take, eat, drink. Come without money, without price, and feast on Jesus Christ. John Rabbi Duncan, I think I mentioned him earlier on, was at the table in the old Scottish way, mid-19th century. Congregation would come forward to the table, and then they would leave, and another group would come forward, and each occasion there would be a little sermon, as it happened, and there would be the passing round of the bread and the passing round of the wine. And Duncan was presiding at the table, and as he saw the cup going round, he noticed there was a woman there sitting, tears streaming down her face, and the cup came to her, and she held it for a moment, and then she passed it on. She felt so unworthy as she examined herself. And when the cup came back round to the mildly but gloriously eccentric Rabbi Duncan, he did something that was outrageous. He picked it up, he got up, he walked round the table to where this tearful woman was. He put it into her hands and he said, take it, woman. It's for sinners. It's for sinners. So we're not talking here about a self-examination that makes us worthy, but a self-examination of our unworthiness, but our longing to be well-dressed in Jesus Christ